And we will start with, well, verbs from the second group. So remember that verbs from the second group are verbs ending with ER. Sorry, I didn't say hello to everybody, but, well, I want to get in the thing, but then I can see that you're there. Bonjour Ice Cube, bonjour Yasmin, bonjour Louisa, bonjour Soem, bonjour Victoria Jacques, Rita Assor is here too, Tenzin, Victoria Posse, Caroline, Hakim, so I mean you're there, Maria Betania, Soem. Tout va très bien, pas de problème, Ashley, mais je vais doucement, mais j'ai peur. Mais c'est pas tellement le vin, Ashley, le risque c'est vous surtout. Je vais bouger, mais alors très délicatement. Okay, so let's start now with the verbs from the second group. So I'm expecting only verbs ending with ER. Okay, we can start with the first one. And the first one is to applaud. How would you translate to applaud into French? Go for it. Alors, we do agree that it's applaudir. Be careful, Yossi, because remember that the verbs from the second group, I mean, they end up with ER. So you don't need to put E in the end. ER will be enough. So applaudir, remember, we've got deux P, and then it goes with AU. So just for the phonetical aspect of it, I will just mention the fact that remember that when you have A, U together, I mean these two vowels, then you will get the sound O, O, O. So applaudir, okay? So this one is not really tricky because they are extremely similar. What about the second one, to blush? How could you say to blush? Well, in French, go for it. Alors, félicitations, so it is rougir, and it's in fact extremely interesting because this second group of verbs, well, like this example, rougir, you will have a lot of verbs that are directly connected to adjectives. So in that case, rougir is of course connected to rouge, blanchir will be connected to blanc, verdir connected to vert, etc., etc. But also for the dimension, grandir, etc., etc. So it's a big group, and then you can see some connections, some direct connections to the adjectives. So let's go for the next one. The next one is to build. To build, so be careful. I mean, we've got several verbs that I could accept, but I only want a verb from the second group, not the third. Merci. Allez-y. Alors, yeah, I was expecting some things like that. So, Hilary, unfortunately, construire, no, because it ends with E and it's the third group. I could accept it if we were doing an exercises for the third group. So construire, Ada, you gave the same. Lisbeth, the same. And then Beaker, the same. So remember that in that case, I would like to have, well, the verb that the others gave, and it's bâtir. If you are like Omar, so if you have this accent circumflex, in that case, don't forget to put it on the top of A. As you can see here, I will change the color. It's not really important, because if you don't have it, don't worry, and especially we don't really pronounce it. But still, it's connected in that case to the noun, un bâtiment. Remember, un bâtiment, it's connected to bâtir, d'accord? So, bâtir would be, the perfect answer in that case. Construire would be okay, but it's a verb from the third group. So in that case, that was not the exercise. What is the French version of to choose? To choose, I'm waiting for you. Alors, to choose, we've got the chance to have Ashley with us, because Ashley is changing totally the language. It's a new group. It's Chosy. Chosy, I don't even know. It must be a fourth group. But of course, he's been correcting that after. Mais I don't go too fast, monsieur. Hein? Alors, it's choisir. Keep in mind that when it comes to the pronunciation, so I will take 1 second for everybody to remember that C and H together, the sound is sh, 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 sh. So sh, it goes like that. And after that, the second thing that is or can be tricky for some persons, it's the O and E together. Remember, O, E together, it's wah, wah, wah. So, first thing, it will be schwa. After that, the S, it's really thin because you've got only one S between two vowels. Zzz, choisir. So, choisir is, the proper verb in that case. Julia, selectir. No, selectir doesn't yet exist. Same thing, we can make a list of the verbs that we can eventually propose for the French Academy. Ashley started that with a fourth group, so we can have selectir in the second group. Let's make a list and offer that to the French Academy. They will be so pleased. To delight, could you give me, please, the translation of to delight in French? Alors, yep, so far it's only, I don't know, we've got Ashley. Ashley was the first one, as usual. Great, because ravir is the verb. We use that when this form, je suis ravi, je suis enchanté, I am delighted. So after that, Ada goes for plaisir. It would make sense, but in fact, plaisir, it's not a verb, Ada. It looks like it, and it's true, IR, but it's not, so be careful. Ravir would be the best option. Je ravis, tu ravis, il ravit, nous ravissons, vous ravissez, ils ravissent. You don't really use it that much, but still, this is really the translation of to delight. And when you say delighted, if you really want to be polite when you are introduced to somebody else, delighted to meet you, ravi de vous rencontrer. This is extremely, extremely polite, and I guess this is what you want to be. So let's see now the translation of to disobey. To disobey, how would you translate that into French? Thank you. Or in fact, if you look at it, it's extremely, extremely close, hein, because basically you have désobéir. So it's quite interesting because this little thing here can be or could be somehow tricky, but remember to really make two different sounds, okay? So you don't combine them. Désobéir first, and then you make the separation, and after that you finish with ir. D'accord? Désobéir. Désobéir, so it's the translation of to disobey, and it's from the, I mean, it's for the, from the second group too. Let's go for the next one, to feel or to feel out. Sorry, one second. Voilà. To feel or to feel out. Alors, Mujahid is joining us. No worries if you're late. Don't worry, we just started. So we tried to find some verbs in that case, and verbs belonging to the second group, d'accord? I'm looking at the same time at the answers of your colleagues, because it's extremely interesting. Probably my pronunciation was not good with the feel, so I guess you went in the sentir, but in fact it's remplir, hein, in that situation. So that was the verb, remplir quelque chose, remplir une bouteille, remplir un verre, hein, because Ashley says that he's got a bright mind today, but I'm pretty sure it's connected with the drink that he's having at the same time. Alors, continuons with to finish. To finish is extremely simple and I hope you know it. Alors, we agree that this one is extremely simple, probably one of the first verbs from the second group that we tend to encounter, and it's finir. D'accord? Finir, donc F-I-N-I-R. Well, this one is not really tricky to pronounce, and for the conjugation, one more time, it's a regular verb from the second group. So it means that for the conjugation, it will be finir, so je finis, I-S. Tu finis IS, il, elle finit IT. Remember, we pronounce them the same way, but of course we write them differently. IS, IS, IT. Then after that, nous finissons, remember, vous finissez, and the last one, ils, elles finissent. So the last one, finis, it will be with ENT as usual for the third person, but then you don't pronounce the ENT. So ils finissent. Okay, and that's it. So to grow, how would you translate to grow into French? Alors, Rupa was offering terminé, beaker terminé tout, yeah. But let's agree that the exercise here is just to propose some verbs from the second group, d'accord? So in that case, terminé is from the first one. And yes, it is a translation, but I only want some verbs from the second group now. « Voilà. And so it's another example, as I told you, I remember when we had rougir. So grandir is another example. It means that there are many verbs from the second group that are connected to adjectives. This one is a good example, grandir, hein, that when you grow or when you get bigger in a way. It could be also grossir. It's another dimension, which happened to me during the lockdown. But this is the way it goes. Alors, so grandir in that case. Remember that when you conjugate it, not when you conjugate, but when you pronounce it, look. Remember that you have your nasal. So one more time, I tend to emphasize on that because it's a main mistakes that people tend to make when it comes to the pronunciation. So a and together, it goes in the nose. So it means that I don't hear any N, and everything is going in the nose. Look at that. So if you press your nose, it doesn't go out because everything is going there. Grandir. Grandir is the verb that we were looking for. Alors, let's have a look now. And I need to click, of course. How would you translate to heal? Alors, to heal, please, in French. Merci. Alors, one more time, Julia is extremely generous because she's making a new gift for the suggestion for the French Academy. Curir, curir n'existe pas encore, but soon it will probably exist. A verb that exists right now is guérir. Alors, for the phonetical aspect of it, look, it's actually quite interesting. So first I will put it in black like that, look. So when you combine these three letters, so it will give you gé, 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 gé. And the sound is gé because of the U. So I will put the U now in red. So it means that without U, the sound would be gé. But because we put the U, then the sound is gé, 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 gé. D'accord? Guérir. Guérir is to heal. So how would you translate to nourish? To nourish in French. Allez-y, s'il vous plaît. Alors, je regarde, et effectivement, so in that case, it's not really difficult, it's quite close, but then we've got two R's in French. Remember, same thing here, so I will just take 1 second to make sure that for the pronunciation, it's clear for you. O and U together, remember, it's OU, 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 make it long, make the sound really long, NOU, 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 and after that you make it shorter, NOURIR. Normally this OU sound, it's not really tricky, but then the U sound can be tricky. I'm talking about the Spanish-speaking persons and the English-speaking persons. To make the difference between POUR and PUR, it can be a nightmare in some cases for certain persons. So in that situation, it's the round one, OU, 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 and it's funny and easy. So let's see the next one. And the next one is something that probably Nicolas should learn from time to time, to obey. Alors, in that situation too, it is not really tricky. Remember the thing for the pronunciation, so I will just take 1 second to hear. It's actually quite interesting because it's exactly the same situation. So we won't combine these two. Normally, remember, when you have a and e together, the sound is e. But if it's a with the accent, it means that you won't combine the two. So you will pronounce it clearly o b first, and after that you finish with the ear, o b ear, and it's really important, d'accord? So don't combine the two, but really make the separation between the two things, o b, and after that ear. Of course, you don't make the pause like I do. So obéir, but really you hear the two vowels, d'accord? Allez, on continue avec the next one, to punish. How would you say to punish in French? Alors, so far, so good. It's really good. So, of course, it is a verb from the second group because this is the exercise ending with ER. And so it's punir. Punir is not really tricky, in fact. Ice Cubes is asking qui a inventé ces accents. And you know what, Ice Cubes? I'm pretty sure it's coming from Latin. So it must be you. Your ancestors probably invented the thing. So don't blame us, but I guess you can blame your ancestors. In fact, it's a good question. I will try to research that just for the pleasure. But let's remember one thing. And I will press on the button. It is not serious at all. It is not serious at all. I can see that Daria, she's looking at the thing constantly. And Daria is the police of the likes. And of course, she's right, because there are 112 persons right now and only 49 likes. It's not really nice. Remember, my little pleasure is to have at least 100 likes per exercise or per stream or per live. So it would be nice. It would be really nice to click and to like this little thing. But then anyways, we'll continue if that's okay with you. So let's go for the next thing. So let's go to reflect or to think. How would you translate that into French? Second group, remember, it must end with ER. This is the concept of the exercise. Alors voilà, so far so good from what I see. Everything is quite okay. It's not really tricky to pronounce. The only thing that probably we should look at is this CH together. Remember, when we combine these two letters, we get the sound sh 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 sh. So it goes like réfléchir. Réfléchir is probably, so the somebody is insulting me again. Soul giver place. I mean, what's the concept of going somewhere and insulting people? It's really, so soul giver place, I'm sorry. I apparently you don't feel good and I feel sorry for you. Please find a nice activity and your life will be better. So let's see what is the translation for the next one. Alors this one too is not really tricky, so normally it should not be a problem, and it is saisir. Hein? Saisir would be the proper translation. Ian is offering tenir, depends on the context. Hein? It's always a question of context. Let's say that the first translation would be saisir. To grab, it would be prendre, tenir, it's slightly different, but really the translation from saisir is to seize in English. So let's look at the next one, and the next one is to succeed. To succeed should be more simple, I guess, no? Alors, we do agree here too that it's réussir. And so réussir, remember, it's exactly the same thing. So I will just take one little minute to really emphasize on that one more time. You have first E accent aigu, and after that you've got U. But you don't combine them like we could combine them if the accent was not there. If the accent was not there, E and U together, it's we agree. But in that situation, you've got this accent. So clearly, you don't combine the two. You will pronounce ré, and after that, usir. And so really, you make the difference between these two vowels. Ré, usir. Réussir, well, is the proper translation of to succeed. Voilà, merci beaucoup, merci beaucoup. Let's have a look at the next exercise.